So tell me, Coco, what brings you to the loony bin?
Well, amigo, that is a sad story. I was married to the love of my life, but it turned out she was having an affair for years. And was some punk kid that hadn't been there the way I had been there for her. And then there's this asshat, Lionel Hambone. He manages the bang my parents went through. Complete cockroach.
But, sir, that's my coffee.
So my parents go in one day because they received a notice from the bank that their home was going to be foreclosed on.
Is the manager available, dear?
Hey there, folks. What can I do you for?
Oh, yes. That was no mistake. You will lose your home in 1 month.
Oh, dear. Oh,
well,
dear.
There's nothing I can do about it. Paperwork's already been filed.
Now, honey, hold on.
Have a blessed day, folks.
Perros, open up. It's time to go, you old bag of beans. Get off my lawn.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh,
now,
dear,
honey,
oh, dear.
Hold on.
Dear. Oh, dear.
Mis parentes didn't even tell me. They died the next week. When I went to visit their graves, intense emotion overcame me, and I vowed to make Lionel Hambone pay. So I went to pay that asshole a visit. Lionel, you son of a bitch!
Now, hold on, Mr. Perro.
They're dead, you fuck!
What?
I was supposed to be notified if they ever missed a payment. Hey, stop! You can't stay locked in there forever. No matter if it takes the rest of my life, it will make you wish you had never crossed the Perros, cabrón. But I never actually killed him. I was only trying to scare him and release some anger. Meanwhile, my wife was attempting to free me. After she found out about the big scene I caused at the bank earlier that day, she decided that this was the perfect time to cut Lionel Hambone's brakes and frame me for murder. Suspects. Once the bank employees testified, I was extremely hostile, and my wife told police I hated Hambone with an intense passion and she thought I'd kill him, I was immediately handcuffed and arrested. This isn't the last you've heard of Coco Perro. Sheet. I gotta think of a way to get out of this hellhole. Hunger strike. Here's some food, Coco. You gotta eat. Here's a pie. Eat. What about a hot dog, Coco? Come on, man. Doctors, I don't know what to do.
He obviously looks mentally distressed.
Yeah, I feel awful. Do you think the loony bin could help?
We'll give it a shot. Hopefully we'll get him eating and sleeping again soon. So, Enoch Desolet.
Kanucky?
Sorry, Kanucky? How'd you get that name?
Well, you know, Nucky is short for Enoch, and I love my hockey and my Vancouver Canucks, so everybody calls me Kanucky, eh? And I'm from Canada.
Fair enough, Kanucky. Tell me why you're here.
Growing up, I was a super smart kid. Got into chemistry when I was just grade one. Also got into hockey. It was all about my dream to be in the NHL. Then one day, a doctor told me I was allergic to hockey pucks. Hockey pucks! I was devastated. Some days I'd forget, just for a second, but then remember and be miserable again. I tried soccer, thinking it was kinda like hockey, but that shit sucks. Too much running and you can only play like a month or year up here. So I stayed miserable. Until I combined my love for science with my love for hockey. I put on my lab coat and started studying. I even acquired an authentic chunk of NHL ice, you know. My goal was to decrease the friction of the ice by making the Zamboni integrate a new chemical that would allow a smoother surface for the skaters. It would increase their speed, reduce injuries, and make for a more entertaining game, eh? I studied it extensively. watching, timing, measuring, and learning. I even drank a little and collected samples to analyze, you know. Then I became the new Zamboni captain. At the first game, which I instituted my chemical additive, I was having a blast, you know. Then it was showtime for me. I zambonied that ice so damn bony good. Then tragedy struck. Apparently, my chemical was too good, and upon re-entry to the ice, the players skated so smoothly they could not control their speed and rocketed into the side barriers, exploding into a fine red dust of blood and bones, you know. I was destroyed, eh? Then, the Canadian Prime Minister banished me from Canada for the safety of hockey players nationwide. He said if I institutionalized myself in the loony bin and pay an incredible fine, I could come back for the Great North. So here I am, eh?
Alright, next we have Oscar Nagar.
What? How do you know that name? I haven't heard that name in years.
So what would you like to be called?
Called? The title is El Flamingo.
Okay, El Flamingo, what brings you here?
I was a simple, closeted homosexual, afraid to venture outside. Until I met Pierre, he made me feel comfortable with who I am. We loved one another. One day, I was working on the railroad with my crew and I took a much-needed break. A welcome surprise rolled up on the bicycle with a bouquet of flowers. Pierre, we embraced. I was so happy to see him. Then the other workers noticed us. They surrounded us. I had no choice but to engage them and try to protect Pierre. But alas, in the scrum, Pierre is tossed on the railroad tracks and run over by the passing train. I'm devastated. I curse my fellow workers. They run and I am left alone, heartbroken. So I decide to hide. I become El Flamingo. I study the weapons and become an assassin. Out, I'm really good. I do not have to interact with anyone, so my identity is safe.
You mean Oscar Nagar?
Shut up. I have no clue what their name is. Physician of a mental institution, Dr. Talis, that looked eerily familiar to my foreman at the railroad, the one responsible for Pierre's death, Mr. Primus. And with my money from the assassinations, I can afford a little personal revenge time. And that's what brings me here, Doc.
Alright, let's see here. Terabyte. Hi, Tara.
Suck it, noob.
Can you tell me why your mom brought you here?
No, ass.
Come on, I heard you like computers. Maybe I can figure out a way to let you access one, if you tell me your story.
Fine. My life used to be awesome. I'd chill in my room coding and developing new modules. I was head cheerleader at my high school. My parents were super supportive, especially my dad. He got me into computers and you could say I was a daddy's girl. I even applied to MIT and was accepted. We were both so happy we danced around like goofballs. But he had to go to work. Little did I know that I'd never see him again. I was broken. I tore up my room, broke all my computer equipment, even shaved my head, because fuck the world. He put on my wig and headphones to drown out the world, but my mom came in and demanded I seek help. And you know the rest.
So what about you, Esse? How'd you end up in the loony bin?
Well, I guess it's only fair. I used to be the head physician here, not Dr. Talos. He was my assistant, and he hated it. He always resented me because I was a younger, more successful version of himself. So he planted prescription pills in my conference room. An officer just happened to be patrolling there. He found them, blamed me, and tore up my medical license in front of me. Then just walked off. I was destroyed. I had been demoted to the assistant, and Dr. Talos became head physician. And that's why I've assembled you all. Here's the plan. Coco Pera will distract the guards by playing the guitar. Tara, you'll hack the mainframe, disarming all alarms. Meanwhile, El Flamingo neutralizes the Southwest Guard, providing a perfect vantage point of the train and sets up his sniper.
The train?
Yes, I'll get to that. While El Flamingo is securing the quadrant, Kanucky, you will be making a hole in the side of the hospital so Coco can escape and board the money train. With the help of Terabyte, who will be operating the crane, Coco will take control of the train and stop precisely under the tunnel. Then, El Flamingo and Coco Pera will load the helicopter, and Tara will take off.
Alone? With all the loot?
Trust me, this is the best plan of attack. If we leave the scene by different means, the Wapoo City Police Department will not possibly be able to track us all, and surely prioritize us on land vehicles rather than a custom helicopter that would easily outrun them.
So, Coco, what brought you to the loony bin?
I was framed for killing some jackass bank manager. Now I kinda wish I had done it. I mean, I'm being punished as though I did. He was a complete turd. Pretty much killed my parents.
Jeez, eh? I would never want to hurt anyone, you know?
I do. I want to hurt till I stop hurting.
This Hambone, though, he was another breed.
Hambone?
Yeah, you know him?
You bastard! That was my father!
But I just said I was framed!
They convicted you, didn't they? You're a horrible son of a bitch. I'll never forgive you.
Tara, wait!
Maybe those headphones are impeding her hearing.
Gee, I hope she feels better, eh?
I'm sorry about your dad. It must be hard losing someone so close.
Even if you didn't, you still wanted him to die. I hate you. I'm not working with you.
Kid, look. Life's hard. There's no bullshitting around that. But what I find most helpful, most satisfying, is teaming up with someone that has a common enemy. My whore ex-wife. She killed your dad and sent me to live in this hell for eternity. So after we escape, Tara, let me and you, with all our money, go and find that evil bitch and give her everything she deserves.
That sounds like a plan, Coco. As hard as it is, I've come to terms with my father being gone. I know it's not your fault. Let's get this money. And get the fuck up out of here. It smells like burning garbage and Axe body spray.
I know. Don't light a match.
All right. Now that everyone's all clear on their mission, let's get a good night's sleep and prepare to be ready tomorrow night, midnight.
And we're just supposed to trust each other? I just met these fools, I say.
And we're supposed to trust you, eh? You're a murderer.
You know that was bogus, Kanagi. I am no criminal.
You guys all seem sketchy. I mean, this doctor just met us and trusts us with this huge robbery. Something must be up.
You guys are some paranoid dudes.
Alright, look. Everybody's got a lot to gain and a lot to lose. Coco, you'd be free. Kanucky, you'd be able to pay off that fine and return your precious Canada. Tara, you'd be able to pursue your father's real killer. And Flamingo,
you can finally get your revenge on Dr. Talus, which, coincidentally, is exactly why I'm doing this.
How much you think we're gonna rake in, eh?
$100 million. $100 million. That's 20 mil each. So pay attention, stay on the radio, and do what you've been trained to do. No mistakes. Just play it cool for the next 24 hours, and don't give any reason for Dr. Talus to suspect anything. Once the job is done, we will rendezvous behind Coco's parents' old home.
Too soon, hombre.
I know, Coco. But we can be sure no one's there since, you know, your parents are dead.
Damn, ese, no chill at all.
Everyone clear?
Clear.
Hey, yo, doctors, check this out.
Oh, he's playing the guitar.
Well, I want to listen.
Me too.
Alarm's down.
They don't trust me. Little do they know, I work at breakneck speed. Kanucky, I got you covered.
Okay, here goes nothing.
Oof.
This is hard, eh? I've got a better way.
There's a breach in the south wall. Kogo's making a run for it. Kill him.
Got the crane. Get on.
Careful, chica.
The train's coming.
All right, team, we've got the train. Kanucky, get to it.
Okay, boss.
All right, let's unload it into the helicopter above us.
Who's piloting that thing?
Some pig I've known for a while.
What?
Excuse me. I can see how you got confused. He's a pig man, not a cop. He goes by Thick Cut.
And you trust him?
With my life. I've known him since he was fatback. Helped him lose quite a bit of weight.
Nice to meet you, Thick Cut.
Likewise.
Alright, boys, get out of here. I've got to get back to the Looney Bin.
Talus, what have you done? You let the inmates escape? And Bill and Ted are fucking dead?
Wait, what? Where have you been?
I was trying to chase Coco. Where have you been? I hope nothing happens as a result of your obvious incompetency.
You don't sound authentic.
Hey, you guys, stop. Damn it, Carl. We lost them. But I think I recognized one of them.
Yeah, boss?
Yeah, a guy I transferred out of prison because he was crazy.
So where'd you transfer him to?
Son of a bitch. The Looney Bin.
Hola, hey. Amigos.
I'm going to see if we were tailed.
Hey, I can see the Looney Bin from up here. The cops are all over that place, man.
Hey, what happened here?
And where are your patients?
Well, sir, we had a breakout. They killed three of our guards, and we believe they were responsible for the money train robbery.
You agree, Doctor?
Yeah. Let's interview each of you. Alone. Carl, watch Gulag.
Yes, sir.
Sounds like you know more than you're telling me. I know it was him. It was Dr. Gulag. What proof do you have? Well, let me get Dr. Gulag in here and talk to him alone. So, Gulag, what do you know?
Nothing. Some things, but nothing about nothing you're talking about.
Huh?
Nothing. You hot? I'm kind of hot.
You're useless.
The cops are all over that place, man. Gulag's talking to that cop.
Do you think he turned on us, eh?
No. He's an honest guy.
But maybe they got to him.
Should we cut him out of the take?
Tara and I followed through on our plan. Kind of. We found out where that whore of a wife was and did make her pay. We begged El Flamingo to do one more hit. Neither of us could bring ourselves to murder someone, but we both desperately wanted her dead.
He did it. She's finally gone.
Finally. Just you and me.
After spending so much time together, Tara and I actually struck up a relationship. She is a true gem. We plan to get married this fall. Kanaki got back into Canada after they pitied him for being in a mental institution and after they received a very, very generous donation to the Canadian government.
Woohoo!
He was able to attend a hockey game again, and no, he didn't operate the Zamboni. El Flamingo overcame his fear of homophobes, finally began socializing and dating again. He may have found something with his new boyfriend, Manuel. Time will tell. And Dr. Gulag?
See ya.
The cops, for some reason, stopped considering him a possible suspect. But we couldn't resist making him sweat a little.
They're gone? Oh no, what about my money? Those scoundrels. Wait, what's this? What? A letter? Oh no, what about my money? Those scoundrels. Oh, I know what that means.
But all's well that ends well, my friends.
That could be dreams. Do, 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 shaboom.
Life could be a dream.
Shaboom.
If I could take you up in paradise up above.
Shaboom.